Archiving is defined as the operation in which the archiver background process copies filled online radiolog files to offline destinations. An offline copy of an online radiolog is called an archived radiolog.
Mic test. Before you enable the archive log mode in Oracle database, you need to decide where you want the Oracle to create archived radiologs. You need a location, and you need to configure the Oracle server to use that location to save archived logs. There are two ways of doing that. These are: configure the fast recovery area, also known as FRA, and configure the archive log destination directory. I have already done a video on fast recovery area. There we discussed how to configure it, what are its advantages, most importantly, why you should configure FRA. You can check that video out. Link is on your screen as well as in the description. Now comes the second option, which is archive log destination directory. That's what we are going to cover in today's Oracle Database Backup and Recovery tutorial. What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Today in this video, I'm going to teach you how to set up archive log destination directory in Oracle Database. So without further ado, let's start the tutorial. There are two main parameters that we need to configure to set archive log destination directory, and these are log_archive_dest_n and log_archive_min_succeed_dest. So let's start with the first one, log_archive_dest_n. Archive log destination directory, as the name suggests, is a location which Oracle uses to save the archived copy of online radiolog files during backup operations. Before we start writing code, there are few things about this parameter that I think you should know. The prefix n is a number in range of 1 to 10. Using this parameter, we can define up to 10 destinations for saving the archive logs. If you have more than one location set up, then you will have redundant copies of archive logs created by the Oracle database server. By default, there is no archive log destination directory set up in Oracle database, which means if you want to use one, then you have to set it up first. Using log_archive_dest_n, you can set up a location which could either be a local folder created on your hard drive somewhere on your system, a network directory, a NAS location, service name if you have a data guard setup. Now let's set up our archive log directory. So I have created a directory in my D drive and named it arclog. We will be using this directory as our archive log destination directory. Now I will log on to my Oracle database using sysuser. Done. Now let's clear the screen. Next, I will write the alter system statement to set our archive log directory. On execution of this statement, we configure our first directory. Let's do that. This directory is the optional archive log directory. Let's talk more about optional and mandatory archive log directory. Any location set as archive log directory using log_archive_dest_n parameter can either be an optional or a mandatory location. By default, any location set using this parameter is optional. What does that even mean? Let's say you have two archive log destination directories created, and both of them are optional. Then the archiver process, the background process which is responsible for archiving your online redo logs, does not guarantee in which directory your redo logs will be written, or even will be written altogether. Now the question is, if by default archive log destination directories are optional, then how and when can we consider redo logs archived successfully? I will answer this in a bit, but before that, I want you to go ahead and comment if you know the answer. And if you don't, you can still come and say hi to me. It makes me feel good. Anyways, okay, so what does it mean to be a mandatory archive log destination directory? As the name suggests, it is mandatory for the archiver process to write the redo logs into the directory, which is defined as mandatory archive log destination directory. hence the name. Creating a mandatory archive log destination directory in Oracle database is actually very simple. We just have to add the keyword mandatory to the alter system statement that we wrote previously, like this.
That's all you have to do. Let's execute. Now from this point forward, whenever you take the backup of your database or perform the backup of redo logs, Oracle will archive your redo logs into this directory. And that's how we create an archive log directory in Oracle database.
Though we have successfully created archive log destination directory, but we are not done yet. Remember in the beginning of the video I said, there are two main parameters that we need to configure to set archive log destination directory, and these are log_archive_dest_n and log_archive_min_succeed_dest. The second parameter, which is log_archive_min_succeed_dest, is still untouched. Also the question, how can we forget about it? The answer to this question is our second parameter, which is log_archive_min_succeed_dest. Let me explain.
This parameter sets the total number of archive log destination directories that need to have successful copies of the online redo logs to be considered as successfully archived. By default, the value of this parameter is set to 1.
That means online redo logs are considered archived successfully only and only when the archiver process creates a valid copy of online redo log files into at least one archive log destination directory.
You can change the value of this parameter to any number between 1 to 10, like this. On successful execution, the number of directories that need to have a valid copy of online redo logs to be called them successfully archived will be 2. Let's execute. Done.
That's it for this tutorial. If you got any value out of this video, then please hit the thumbs up button. Otherwise, feel free to hit the thumbs down. But do make sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, press the bell icon to get notified, because many more such interesting tutorials are coming your way. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.